Man, you know, it's that old thing, you know, perseverance, consistency, hard work, you know what I mean? My goal is to put the same work into, you know, my businesses, my family, that I put into football, you know, and I've been running with that mantra since, you know, since I got married back in 97, you know, that if I'm going to have a successful marriage, I got to, you know, the same hard work and same consistency and discipline I had on the football field, I got to put in my marriage and with my kids and with my businesses and all that. So it teaches you a lot, man, you know, how to deal with your fellow man and not look at his color, but look at, you know, what he can do for the overall good of what you're trying to accomplish, you know. So, sports to me in general is just an incredible deal. When you talk about football specifically because of the closeness of guys, I just believe it's an amazing sport.
Another edition of Talking Ball with the Czar. I'm Emory Hunt, the Czar of the Playbook, here on the campus of Hiram College in Ohio with head football coach Henry Stanford. Coach, appreciate you taking time.
No problem.
A lot of people look at wins and losses as a measure of success, and we know that's not the case when you're talking about football and building a college football program.
Correct.
Because it has been a lot of success here, a lot of progress in when you took over the head coach job a few years ago. Where you are in your building process and what does that process look like?
Pretty much for us, when we came into the position, you know, the great thing about it is that myself and one of the assistant coach was assistants, and we kind of saw the program from the inside, and as time went on and then the opportunity happened that we moved into new roles, we knew about what we had to do to get things going in the right direction. And since then, we've been kind of going through the process of adding the culture and adding the different aspects to it that a winning program is all about.
Because that takes a lot of time when you look at buy-in. And you're talking about buy-in from the players, the assistants, the administration, the fans, the community. How do you go about getting that buy-in from everyone to really build this thing forward?
I think what's all said and done, you got to understand it's a family. It's got to be a family. It's got to be buy-in from everybody. It's got to be the administration. It's got to be the trainers. It's got to be the maintenance crew. Everyone's got to be pulling rope in the same direction. And some of your best programs in the country, they do that. You go on their campus on game day, everybody's hitting all the cylinders the same way. So first thing you got to do is make sure everybody understands what you're trying to accomplish. That is more than just football. It's about developing young men long-term wise. And that's the one thing we try to do here is that we're just not trying to build a great football team. We're trying to create great men. And we call men of Hiram. And we're trying to build men of Hiram that's going to be representation on the football field, but also in the classroom and in the community as well.
Yeah, one part about that building process that a lot of people don't understand is it involves tradition. And to be honest, this is a tradition-rich program, a lot of history here. How important is tradition to you, and how do you go about getting that to the players that's coming in?
That's the big thing for me is tradition, because when you talk about tradition, you also bring in the word pride. And we have a rich tradition of a program or an institution. You have to let the players understand that tradition, understand what are you representing. You represent yourself, your family back home, but even bigger than that, you represent the college and the program and the tradition that they've been here at the college. So we do a lot of buy-in with our players about, you know, you're representing not just yourself, representing everyone else on this football team, representing everybody that ever wore a jersey, representing the guys and gals that's in the stands that are proud alums of Hiram. You represent all of those guys.
Yeah. I'm an offensive guy myself, so I love that you are an offensive guy. Yeah. I went in your office, saw touchdown, lit me up. I was like, perfect. So. When you talk about offense in this day and age of college football, it's spread out. Yeah. Some teams are able to marry both. You guys do a lot of multiple things within your offense. How do you go about building your offense in this day and age, and how have you been so successful?
I think the biggest thing about what we do offensively and the success we've had over the years is that we are a offense that looks at what we have. And we're not one to look at other programs and, oh, this program does that they do this. Mm-hmm. We find out what our guys do well. And we try to eliminate the things that they don't do well and emphasize the thing they do well. And that's where it all starts, is that we have a base offense, and then from there we find out what our guys can do. And then from there we give them in positions to make plays, let's let them do their job. And so it's an exciting offense. Gets the ball in a lot of guys, you know, in open space. It lets them do what they do their whole lives. But also the thing that's kind of hidden is that we also glorify the linemen too, because we put them in position to make great plays. So we have a 5 linemen that are great guys in open space running screens and stuff. That's their forte. And you know, 1 year we had an All-American caliber tackle, and he was great in as far as reach blocking. So we ran a lot of outside zone with him because we wanted to showcase his ability to run on 2 feet. And surprised enough, now he actually races cars now and stuff. So it's like he's the need for speed is in his system and stuff. But that's what we kind of do in our office, is that we find what we do very well. We showcase that with our players. We try to stay balanced with run and pass. And the one thing we talk about a lot is, if you give us the pass, we're gonna give the pass. And if you give us a run, we're gonna run the football. But we want to try to stay balanced in everything we do, from play calling standpoint, also production standpoint.
So what you're saying basically is football is an easy game.
Yes.
When I say that to people get mad at me and saying I'm oversimplifying football, yeah. But it really is. Can you explain in depth of what that philosophically means?
It's very easy. When it's all said and done, football comes down to guys up front establishing the line of scrimmage. It comes down to getting the ball in playmakers' hands in space. It comes down to just having continuity and executing the game plan and understanding what teams are going to try to do to stop you. And then counter that with what you're going to do. So it's very easy from the standpoint of, as long as you're solid and confident in what you do offensively, and you know what your limitations are and what you're great at, as long as you put your young men in a position to make great plays, it's really easy to me, in my mind.
It's not that hard, Coach. And it's really not that hard. If you talk about building blocks. You are offensive coordinator, coach of the year in this conference at Capital. And when you look at philosophy, I'm big on philosophy because it gives you a chance to understand the why of what you do. Mm-hmm. What would you say your coaching philosophy is?
My coaching philosophy is really, it comes down to a couple of things. The number one thing for me when it comes to our program and to our players is that we're trying to build a culture of excellence. We're trying to instill in our guys that every day you wake up, you are achieving greatness. You're trying to go out and be the best example of who you are. And some days you may get knocked in your can for that day and the next 5 days in a row, but guess what? It's a day 6, it's a day 7. And that goes into kind of our philosophy, is ring the bell. And then people say it's kind of a cliche thing and things of that nature. But to us, ring the bell is every day of your life, it's a new round of boxing. You know, it's a new round, a new opportunity. You may have a rainy day yesterday, but guess what? Today the sun came out, the birds are twerping. So you got to move on. You can't dwell too much on the past. You got to move forward. And so my philosophy is always looking for the next potential thing, the next building block, the next opportunity to get great in what we do. Second thing I would say with our philosophy is that the game is all about the players. You know, giving them opportunity to showcase their ability on the football field, but also give them opportunity to showcase their ability off the field as far as leadership development, mentorship development, life skills training. When a student athlete leaves our program in 4 years with their diploma, they can say that they're well-rounded. They are a man of Hiram. They're well-rounded. They're able to go into a boardroom and command the boardroom. Likewise, they did well in the football field. So that kind of goes along to the same thing as giving our student athletes tools as far as on the football field and off the field, building them with tools and things. So that's kind of my philosophy when it comes to football, is that it's not just football, it's life in general, and trying to build all aspects to you, but it all comes down to just giving our young men opportunity to just be themselves and do great.
We know football is one of those games that it's a physical discussion out there every Saturday, and it definitely teaches you a lot. Right. What would you say is the biggest thing football has taught you?
The biggest thing that football taught me was that no matter what happens on that previous play, the next most important play is the next play. It taught me perseverance. It taught me how to believe in myself. And it taught me that I am my greatest fan, that I'm going to be critiqued, I'm going to be ridiculed, they're going to talk about me, they're going to say all the negative things they want to say about me. I can't play, I can't catch, I can't throw, I can't block, I can't tackle nobody, I can't cover. But guess what? I got to look at myself in the mirror and say that I'm my biggest fan. I'm my biggest opponent. Likewise, I'm also my biggest opponent, that I got to play for myself, for my unit, for my college, for my institution. But it all comes down to having confidence in your ability and not letting anyone or anybody or any entity shake your confidence, and really believing in that the struggle is going to get better. That, and it goes back to the perseverance, that Football is the greatest sport in the world in my mind because you get knocked on your butt, but then there's the next play. Likewise, when you go get up off the field, there's 10 other guys that's trying to help you up. That's truly a family. It's about teamwork. It's about continuity. It's about chemistry. It's about us together, 300, going against the world. And that's what football taught me, was that I got to rely on other people who's relying on me to do my part, but also I got to be confident in myself that I can accomplish what's being asked of me. And I wouldn't have learned those lessons if it wasn't for getting my butt kicked and kicking butt on the football field.
That was going to be my next question about, yeah, would you have learned that lesson? Mm-hmm. To be involved in the game for this long, like you have, player, coach, mm-hmm, it shows that you have to love the game. What is it about the game you love the most?
What I love about football is that I'm able to teach young men life. I'm able to teach them that in a football setting, you can have the greatest game in the world, and the next week, the worst game that you ever played. But guess what? There's another game next week. So it teaches our young men that adversity is a part of living. Perseverance is a part of living. Having high points in your life is a part of living, but also having bad days is a part of your living. And that I can rely on other people to get me going and to get them going. I can also rely on myself to be mentally strong myself to do my very best the next day, the next minute, the next hour, whatever the scenario may be. Football taught me, and what I love about football is that it teaches that if you execute something very well, you can be very successful. And that goes back to investment. I'm buying into what I'm doing. I'm buying into the guys I'm around. I'm buying into the program, the college, the institution. It taught and it teaches that if you're doing something the right way, you get a very positive result to that effort. And you have it in all sports, but I think in football in particular, because it's such a physical game and it is such a game where it's two wills going against each other and who has a stronger will, it teaches you more in any other sport that I've seen outside of MMA, UFC, or true boxing. Yeah.
Getting here, Coach, taking a look at the facilities, outstanding facilities, number one.
Thank you.
Number two, it's a really good program, really good area. And we know the country has kind of become smaller to where everyone can either watch you on the streaming device or television or what have you.
Right.
So student athletes are making more informed choices of where they want to go to school and play ball. Mm-hmm. Why would a student athlete choose Hiram?
If I was a student athlete looking at Hiram College right now, I would be excited because of several reasons. Number one, no matter where you are in the country, we'll come and see you. We are known for going throughout the country, searching for talent, both as a person and also as an athlete. So no matter if you're in Arizona, in California, Texas, Florida, the DMV, or in New York State, if you're invested in Hiram and want to be a part of our program, we're going to come out and see you. We're going to come either visit you, watch you play a game, watch your highlight, come to your high school and see you. So you know that we're going to give you love. We're going to spend our time and efforts to get to you to show you what we're all about. The second thing I would say for a student looking at us that makes you excited is that the new design of our program, in a sense of we've just gone through a academic redesign on campus, that it's exciting. It's bringing a lot of majors that we never had before, like criminal justice and sports management, which are heavy majors for a lot of students right now. And our tradition academically is such that we could get these young people in positions for positions of power, you know, within their time as doing internships and job shadowing, and also when they go to graduate, going on to do great things as well. So if a student comes to Hiram, we can help them get to the job of their dreams. And that's something we've proven already, and with these new majors, is really going to be something big for us. A third thing I would say for a student looking at Hiram is that if you invest your child into our program and you send your child to us as a football program, we're going to take care of him. Your son, when he leaves 4 years from now, is going to be a different person. You're going to come to report day in the coming weeks and have a bright-eyed and bushy-tailed freshman that's trying to figure out what this is all about. 4 years later, you're going to be sitting in the auditorium, and he's wearing a black gown, shaking the president of Elias' hand, and he's going to talk different. He's going to walk different. He's going to think different. He's going to be a well-rounded, holistic person. And he's going to have 4 years of excellence on the football field to show for as well. So you're going to have a person in 4 years that you're going to blink and say, is that my son? because he's going to be a different entity. And if we've done our job correctly, which we're going to work our butts to do, he's going to become what we call a man of Hiram, a person that is well-renowned in the classroom, in the community, but also defended our program on the football field. And I, kind of to our horns, I think we do that. I think that we take young men and we help them buy into, I'm great. Life may tell me I'm bad, but I'm great. I look good, I do great things on the football field, but also guess what? I do great things in the classroom, connecting with professors. I do great things in community, connecting with potential employers. I do great things because I open doors for people. I say yes, sir, no, sir, yes, ma'am, no, ma'am. The college can rely on me to be a great representation of the school. That's what you're gonna get from your son if you bring your son to our program and have him be a part of it. Is that if we do our job as coaches, you're gonna have a well-rounded young man that's gonna do great things in life, and that's what we do in our program. It's just how we design it, and that's how we're gonna produce it.
I'm excited about it. I've seen stuff that you've done on film, and I was like, okay, this is going to be good. Once he gets a few more pieces involved, they're going to be outstanding. And the foundation that you've laid so far here, and you're going into your third year. I think it's just on the brink of being successful and really breaking through. And we wish you the best luck moving forward.
Appreciate it. Really do. Thank you.